the envelope, please. Thank you. Thank you very much. Let's see what we got going on this time. How to improve resolution. Wow. We could come up with some novel. We got some ways to do that. We're kind of experts at improving resolution, so to speak.
Yeah, that's a pretty multifaceted question there.
Yeah. Resolution comes at from all different angles, right? The transducer, the electronics, the source material. It's kind of that. It's kind of like the details video we did, how to listen for details. So,
yeah.
That was more of a topic on just listening. I think this question is more like, how do you approach getting more resolution out of a system or existing system?
Well, I think the first step is knowing where your weakest link is, and how to improve it then.
Yeah. So like most things in systems, resolution especially, at least, tends to be very impacted by the cumulative performance of the chain. And so if you have one thing that's underperforming, it's going to have a big impact on everything else. You could have the world's best everything, but if one piece of gear is really lacking, it's going to most likely totally devastate the resolution of the rest of the gear. And so I guess there's a bit of a challenge there, because sometimes it isn't always clear and certain what's causing that problem.
Yeah, the one way to do it would obviously be trying different components to see if something makes a dramatic change. You know, it could be the headphones, could be the amplifier, could be all of it. That's kind of difficult. One thing that I know from the cable side of things, because we make cables, is and I've tweaked as in improved upon, you know, thousands and thousands of systems over the years, as our customers have. You know, there's hundreds of thousands of customers that have gone through cable and many other manufacturers' cable. The thing there is that they use them to help tune the system for them, for themselves, for the drivers, for the speakers, for the headphones, you know. And I'm not saying that you necessarily want to use cables as tone, a lot of them like that. In our case, something like as simple as a power cord on the headphone amp or something could make tremendous difference in improving resolution. Let's say, Jason, right? You take something that's, you know, like a halfway decent amp, right? I mean, what can you do with it, right, with cables?
Well, it depends on the amp, really. Some stuff's more affected than others, obviously. You know, the better amps usually are more affected by better cabling. And as you put better cables on them, you usually open that amp up to its full potential. The problem is actually getting to the point where you know what specific component you want to tweak and improve with cables, though, I'd say.
Yeah, well, power cords are kind of cool because you can actually take one of them and try it on multiple devices and just see what it does.
That's true. You know? That's true.
Like in our lineup, like I got cables going all over the place here, like this Captivator light. You know, it's a real tricked out cable, and we designed it to flush resolution out of a piece without being bright. So it's got, you know, very novel. It's using Kapton as insulators and custom conductors and, you know, nice watt gate gold plug and all this stuff. But the materials are high quality, and it's made to say, okay, compare this to, like, you know, like say a stock cord, you know, like someone mentioned, we call it a Black Beauty in house, right? It's the typical black cable power cord. You know, you're already supplying power to the device, right? But now you're taking a power cord that's got much higher, the capabilities of bringing out resolution to the device are way higher because of the materials it's made out of. And you take that one cable or power cord, and you could plug it into your amp or your DAC, and it gives you, by being purposely designed to flush out resolution, it gives you the ability to hear that piece even more so, like you said, Jason. You know, you got a good piece, you'll make it sound even better. And vice versa is true too, right? If it's a shitty piece, not a very good sounding piece, then technically putting a higher end cord on it could make it worse, because now you're not only flushing out, when you flush out resolution, you flush out the negatives and the positives. So, but I found that to be a good thing, though, to have at least one cable like that, because now you really get to hear what each component can do or where it's going. And so it also shows you what the weak link is easier, because now you put a high resolution part on say a DAC, and now the DAC goes bright. It's like, well, okay, first of all, you got to question whether it's the cord or not doing that. But, you know, again, in talking to us about it, we can kind of, if it goes the wrong way and the cord is truly being neutral about it and just bringing out res and not acting like a tone control, then that's probably the way the DAC's going to go no matter what you do with the system. So as you do try to improve on, say, cabling, the headphones, the amplifier, you're already knowing that that DAC's probably going to be a weak link in the chain because of what you just flushed out of it early on. You're saying, well, I already know that it has a propensity to go in that direction. So I'm gonna keep my eye on that piece as I try to improve resolution throughout the chain. So you back the cable down on that, a power cord on that, and you put, say, on the amplifier, you try a cord like that and see what it does. So higher resolution, just even one cable, even an interconnect too, right, can point you in a direction. It's a clue to where to go.
Yeah, I think that's the biggest thing is you learn what components like what, and then it gets easier to know what you're going to need to change in the future in your specific system and setup.
Yeah, I mean, that's called experience, right? It's a learning curve. Yeah, and I mean, even sometimes you get top shelf stuff, and you can't always flush it out. I mean, it could sound really good with a stock cable, a stock power cord, and sometimes you got to flush it out and it just goes the wrong way. And then, you know, and then you got to look at the piece and go, well, okay, you know, is it this or is it something else? You know, like, for example, like, you know, the confusing part gets, so let's say you put a high resolution cord and now it sounds better, but now you're hearing something else that you don't like. Now that you've raised the system res, particularly at the tail end of it, at the amplifier end, everything else becomes more critical upstream. The interconnect connecting the DAC, the power cord on a DAC becomes more obvious. The music, you know, the recordings, the quality of the recording. So resolution is a double-edged sword, so to speak. And, you know, it will tend to lead you on a path to spending more money because ultimately you're probably looking for better and better gear to match that resolution, right? So, but yeah, you got to be aware of that just because you put, say, a better power cord in the amp and now something sounds better in one respect than another, it might not be that cord in that amp. You could just be flushing out, say, the sound of the interconnect or the power cord on the DAC or somewhere else in the stream or some noise from the computer. So, yeah. And at that point, maybe you got to back away a little bit or maybe try a different interconnect. Maybe it's giving you a problem now. So it's definitely an experimentation process. Yeah. I mean, what about our headphones, for example? Like, you know, we have three different models and really they make steps in resolution from low to high. It's kind of a similar time thing, you know, we're giving you, right? I mean, Dynafi, V2, well, let's go in order. Dyna V2, Dynafi, and the, obviously the big boy, the 1266.
Yeah, so we effectively designed Dyna V2 for people that have a preference of not necessarily hearing every possible detail. And that may sound derogatory in some sense, but it's actually preferable. So in certain situations, especially if you have really bad recordings, you have old recordings that weren't done particularly well or some new recordings that also weren't done particularly well, sometimes it isn't always that great. It isn't always that musical to have uber resolution. And so sometimes it's actually helpful to have a little bit of a limit in that. And that's kind of what we designed Dyna V2 for. It's a little bit softer and it's a little bit more forgiving on less stellar recordings and systems. So if you don't want to make the leap of faith and try to resolve every possible detail you can and go down the inevitable rabbit hole that it seems to have follow, Dyna V2 seems to be a good calling for most.
Well, not only that, not everyone can afford, you know, $5,000 or $10,000 headphone amps. So,
right.
It tends to be a better choice if you're not willing to go that far with the electronics, at least not now. And still the V2 will scale. I mean, it's clear. We're just not giving you that crazy res that's available on the upper model. So, yeah, it's purposely done. You know, I mean, Jason, you listened to the three of them over here on our, you know, on some of the amps I have here at home with W33 and stuff. I mean, step people through it. Like, you know, what do you notice between you have them at home too? So, how do you explain to people what resolution change is on three different model headphones? Right.
Well, I mean, tonally, they're all like very similar. That's the thing.
Yeah.
They all sound similar. But as you increase resolution, it gives you like the sense of where it was recorded, like the space it was recorded in. You get that. You just get, you know, more, you know, atmosphere, I guess you'd say, that you can't hear as much. It's still there on like the V2, but not to the level of a TC or a Phi.
Yeah, I mean, I think we need to understand, though, like between our three model headphones, we should make some corrections. I think we should make it clear, though, like between our three model headphones, they all resolve to a really high level. I mean, relative to, let's say, anything in its price class or beyond. What we're doing, though, is we're not trying to create the ludicrous resolution that's available in the AV1266, because that driver, that headphone, that assembly, that whole thing goes beyond current day electronics. And it really does. I mean, it will continue to resolve probably 20 years from now more than the electronics will. And it's just inherent in playback design. It's just the way the current limitations in playback are what they are. Where the V2 still has the resolution of, say, the big guy, but at some point, who knows when in the future, you may tap that out. But on the positive note of that is that some people really aren't geared for all that resolution. They either don't want it, their recordings won't support that kind of resolution, the electronics won't support that resolution. So, you know, it's not like the headphone is muted in any way. It's clear, but it has a lower ceiling to its res than as you move up arc chain. And that's really, there is something to be said about it. There is a ceiling to resolution. And guys that have high-end systems know that. They'll go through, and let's say, and usually this goes in waves, okay? They'll go through, and let's say you've got your speakers in place, your amp, right? Your system's in place, playing music. Now you play with cables. You choose your power cords as wisely as possible, your interconnect as wisely as possible. Everything sounds pretty good, right? Now you get somewhere along the way, you get the bug to change one thing. And this could be a year down the road, 2 years, it could be a month. It's their own speed of things. Yeah. So now you get a new, let's say you upgrade the DAC, you get a new DAC, right? Well, technically speaking, now that DAC, let's say that DAC just raised the bar on resolution of the entire system through the chain. You're hearing stuff you've never heard before, which means now the choices you made first go around, may not be the best for this current system, because now you've got newfound res that you're hearing through, you know, that you're hearing more into the recordings, you're hearing ambience, right? Now, all of a sudden, with that information coming from the source available to you, you could probably make even better decisions on, let's say, the headphones or the amp or the interconnect cables or a power cord on the amp. So this stuff tends to go with experience and goes in waves. Ultimately, you know, if you got enough money, you could carry this out to the nth degree.
All right, that seems like a good enough place to stop. If you like what we're doing here, subscribe to the channel, leave a comment down below, and maybe we'll use it in a future video.
Thanks for watching, everyone. Take care.